Welcome to Conscious Coupling, where Frederick Gobet and Christy Whitman share their experiences of creating a conscious, connected relationship. Every week, they give practical tools, steps, and processes to help you find the loving connection with your partner. Let's get into today's conversation with Frederick and Christy.
Do you mind if I go play golf on Sunday with my friend Jack?
No, I don't mind, except for Sunday's Mother's Day.
Oh, I didn't think about that one. That's true. So do you mind if I go maybe next week?
Go sometime? Whenever. Yeah, whenever you want to go.
Cool.
So this is actually a discussion that we have. So hello, everyone. If you want more information on how to make your relationship more solid, more connected, more conscious, go to connectedcoupling.com. But we are here today to talk about asking permission and the other side of the spectrum, doing whatever the hell you want to without considering your partner. So
there's two ends, basically, is what she's trying to say. There's one end, which is you kind of need to ask permission. You're not sure if your partner is going to accept or if it's going to fit in what you want to do. And the other end is you don't care. You're going to do it whatever matters, and you're not necessarily taking your partner into consideration.
Absolutely.
So we want to teach you how to do it properly together so that it's being done in a better communication kind of way.
Yeah, and so why this is an issue and why we brought this up is because we had this in our relationship where he would ask me permission. It was almost like, do you mind if I... Instead of, you know what, babe, I really feel like I need some guy time, or myself, I really feel like I need some Christy time. When would be good for me to go and get a massage, or when would be good for me to go golf with my friend, or something like that. And, you know, one side of the spectrum is you're acting like almost like a kid in school. Can I go to the bathroom, right? Or mommy, can I, or daddy, can I do this? You don't have to ask permission to your partner, but you really come from a place of, I'm needing guy time, or I'm needing a girl's weekend, or I'm needing just time off to go get a massage, or I'm needing time just for myself to just go get lost for a few hours, right? And being able to come to your partner, not with that, do you mind, kind of wishy-washy kind of place, but saying, hey babe, I really feel like I need some extra time for myself this weekend.
And for us, that was an understanding in our relationship that we both needed, or we both agreed that we needed some time for each other in order to replenish our battery, if you want to say that, in order to come back to, you know, the all of the responsibilities of the family and taking care of the kids and just being present with each other. It's important, we know that for each other, it's important to take our me time, right? So yes, when she comes to me and says, I need to take some time for myself, I'm glad that she takes time for herself, and vice versa. Same thing for her. She is so happy when I take time for myself, because she knows that when I come back, I'm fresh, I'm happy, I'm in the best of moods, actually, because I took some time to go and do what I love to do.
He's more present, he's more patient, you know, and the same thing for me. So it's like, we call that Christy time and Frederick time, right? So it's like, whatever that looks like. And sometimes along the way, we've had to negotiate it, because there was a point where, you know, we had two babies pretty close together, they're 16 months apart, and we always decided that Saturday mornings would be my time to go get a massage. It's where I don't have to be a businesswoman, I don't have to be a wife, I don't have to be a mother, a daughter, a friend. I just get to be Christy without roles, without responsibilities, doing whatever I want to do. And he would do the same thing on Sundays. Well, a massage at best is 2 hours. Yes, I would get 2-hour massages. They're wonderful. I recommend it. And yet he would go golfing. And sometimes with travel time and golf time, it would be 5, sometimes 6 hours. And there was a part of me that felt like, well, this kind of isn't fair. I don't feel this is fair. You're gone half the day on Sunday. I get 2 hours on Saturday. And instead of holding it in, I did a little bit. I started feeling resentment. And then I came to him and said, you know what? I'm starting to feel a little bit of resentment. Like, it's not fair. Like, I get this amount of time on Saturdays. You get almost the half the day. You know, what could we work out? What are our options, which we're going to talk about in another show? And obviously, for him to cut golf short, that wouldn't feel good. You know, that's him and his ability to go and have that total time, you know, is like we talked about, instead of doing an 18 hole, I could do a nine hole, but that just didn't feel good to him. And so I said, well, what if I do this? After my massage, I don't come rush home and come right back into it. If I want to go shopping, or if I want to go to lunch, or if I want to do something else, it's not like I get the massage time and have to come back home. I can take my time and be leisurely coming back home and doing what I want. And that felt good for both of us and worked for both of us. And as we went along the way, when we were in Montreal, the kids had karate, right? So I would go do my massage, meet them so I could watch the kids karate. And then after that, he would go to lunch maybe with his mom and the kids. And then I would go meet a friend or go shopping or, you know, do whatever I wanted to do to still feel like I had my time. Other times I felt like I'm good. I don't need to take the rest of the time. But just having that option for myself, to have that no pressure on myself, no responsibilities, you know, just complete freedom to choose, what do I feel like doing? Do I feel like going and getting a coffee and journaling somewhere? Do I feel like seeing a friend? What do I feel like doing without any scheduling, without any, you know, restrictions of any kind? And that was really important.
And I think that what's important here and what we want to say is that it's important to communicate together and not come from a place of resentment, right? And a place of fear, or a place of where there's frustration going on, and you don't feel like you're having some time for yourself. We all know, right? We've got busy lives. We've got work. We've got, you know, family. There's kids. There's always something that
puppies.
Needs to be done. Puppies, exactly. And so it is very important for us, again, what we've learned in our relationship. It's very important to start to take care, continue taking care of ourselves.
Yes.
Feed us, right? Feed that that energy bubble inside of us. So what's important is communicate together, say what you say, what's going on inside, instead of keeping it in and being resentful and feeling like, oh, my husband's always out and I'm the one that's always taking care of the kids. I'm the one that's staying at home. It's been 3 months that I haven't done anything for myself. Well, that's not okay. You can talk about it and just sit down with your husband and say, why don't we talk about, you know, I need to have some time for myself. I'd like to talk, you know, to see how we can make that happen, even on a regular basis. For us, Saturday for her, Sunday for me, worked good. It works awesome.
And we had to adjust things along the way because now the kids are playing soccer, so Saturdays weren't convenient. So I would get my massage on Friday night and maybe take some time later in the afternoon on a Saturday. So it's just finding out, you know, even considering the stuff that's going on. But the point I wanted to make is that it's not an if, it's a when. So it's not like, well, if I get to go play golf, right? It's not an if. He wants to go. It's important for him to fuel himself, to have guy time, to do whatever he wants to do. So it's like, when is a good time for me to play golf this weekend, right? If Sunday's not going to work, when's a good time this week? You know, what have you got going on this week? When would be a good time for me to go play golf? Instead of a, you know, could I, maybe, if. It's not an if, it's a when. Right? And when you're coming to your partner with a, this is really what I feel I need or prefer, you know, then it's not like you're asking for permission. And I wanted to touch on the other aspect of that. We became, you know, aware, because we're not used to being around individuals like this, and I know this exists out there, and you might be married or in a couple with someone like that. But we went to San Diego to work with a couple that I was working for a short period of time in my business. And we were going to be in town for my book tour. And so I had a lot of, you know, TV stations that I was going to. Frederick was coming with me, and we were, you know, touring. Had a limo that was driving us around from TV station to TV station and doing different media appearances and things like that. And at nighttime, we were staying at this couple's house. Well, the first day we get in, you know, the next day is when my tour started. First day we get in, the guy says, well, I'm out, I'm gonna go play hockey. And we're like, what?
I think it was actually the first hour, right?
Yeah, we get in, we say hi,
we kind of shake hands and hug, and then he's like, okay, well, I'm leaving for my hockey game. And we look at each other, we're like, wait a minute, what's going on? You know, for us, it's like, well, aren't you guys entertaining us since we're at your house?
Are we going to dinner tonight? I thought that was the plan. Yeah, but I need to go to hockey.
Yeah.
So we had dinner with the female, with the wife, and we had a lovely dinner, but it was very different. And it was like, you know, instead of saying to us, not in asking permission, because nobody has to ask us our permission, but it's like, hey, really needed this hockey time. I hope you guys understand. How do you feel about that? We would have been like, okay, we were looking forward to spending time with you, however, but it wasn't like that. It was like, I'm doing this without considering anybody else in the mix. And so that's not what we're talking about. We're not talking about that kind of behavior where you don't consider your wife, your husband, your partner, and that you don't just, you're like, I'm doing this, you know, like if he was to say, I'm golfing on Wednesday, okay, well, the kids this, and you know, it would be a very different conversation than, hey, I really want to golf this week. I have an opportunity to golf on Wednesday. Is that a good time with everything we have going on with the kids? Look at the schedule. Yeah, it looks great, right? Or no, Maxim has a presentation on Wednesday. Do you want to be there? Oh, shoot, I did. Maybe I'll play on Thursday instead. So it's kind of like a negotiation, right? It's not like a business thing, but we figure out, where's the compromise? Where does it fit in? Where does it work? So that you're considering your partner. Number one, you're considering yourself, which you always have to do. We are all individual people in the relationships. And I was even telling Frederick this morning as we were driving the kids to school, there's all these love songs that are like, oh, I can't live without you, and who am I without you? And I'm like, ugh. You know, it's like it's so fused together, like I'm nothing without you. No, I'm me. I'm me with a channel of my divine self. I have divinity flowing through me, energy that flows of creation and of ideas and my desires, and I have my own preferences and my own, you know, things that I want to achieve and do and be and have. And he has too. And so it's like what the Council of Light talk about is that my true life partner is my life, is my breathing, is my divine self, is my life force. And then he has his life partner, which is his breath, his life. And then we get to exchange and co-create together. But in this relationship, you know, we first have to be fed on our own, have to be energized on our own, have that containment on our own. And if we're so depleted because we're giving, 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 and we don't take that time for ourselves, he's been like doing so much work with the kids on their projects and, you know, training the puppy. We got a puppy about a month ago.
Soccer,
just doing so much. And it's like, I'm encouraging him, go play golf, do something for yourself, take that time, because I know that he's needing that, I can see. And so it's a nice reminder, you know, for me when I get like that too, if he sees I'm overworking or doing too much or giving too much, he's like, hey, do you have a massage scheduled, or do you have something that you're, you know, doing for yourself? And just to be that reminder of take time for yourself, you know? But we have to be able to fill ourselves up first, and because you have nothing to give if you're depleted. So it's important to constantly feel that connection that you have with abundance, with success, with love. And as you fill yourself up first and have that containment of energy for yourself, you give from the overflow. And so asking yourself, what do I need? What do I prefer? Do I need to take a time out? Do I need some girlfriend time? Do I need a weekend away? Do I need a night out? You know, what is it that you need that you would plug you back in? Maybe it's a meditation weekend or joining an online course or, you know, something like that that would really fill your cup. By the way, if you want more tips and more information, you want to do some coaching with us, you can go to connectedcoupling.com to really improve your relationship and get one-on-one or two-on-one coaching from Frederick and I. So let's give him the tools to wrap it up. Tools to wrap it up so that you can, you know, it's really important to have this type of awareness, right? And you might have ahas. But it's really in the implementation, and that's why we give steps to help you during these particular podcasts so that you can know what to do to take away. So number one, you have to check in with yourself. You have to be plugging in with yourself, with your divine self, with your source of all good. Energy is everything, and you know all that is everything. All that is energy. And so when you feel depleted in your energy, you must hook up to your life force. And whether that for you might be exercising, or it might be meditating, or it might be going and getting some kind of massage or spa work, or going golfing or fishing, or
maybe it's just sitting down on your favorite lawn chair in the backyard with your coffee for about 5 minutes, where you inhale, you take deep breaths. That's what I love to do sometimes in our backyard, and it's just taking in all of the nature. And it just refocuses me, actually. So it really doesn't take much time. Sorry, create a habit of doing that, making sure that you come back to yourself.
Absolutely. So that's number one, is you have to check in with yourself. And number two is you have to communicate with your partner, not in a way where you're asking permission. Do you mind if, could I maybe? No, babe. I really need to take some time for myself this weekend. How is this weekend looking for Saturday?
Right. Right. So like you said, it's a negotiation, it's a contribution with each other, and it's not asking a permission. It's just saying and having an understanding that you need some time for yourself.
Absolutely. And then the third step is when you go and take that time, do not let yourself feel guilty, shameful, afraid, any of those things. While you're getting that massage, don't feel like, oh my God, I'm the worst mother ever because I'm taking time away from my kids. No, not allowed. You cannot feed that time with worry and frustration. Take a time out. Imagine taking your worries, taking your things that you have to worry about. The kids are gonna be fine, your husband's gonna be fine, your wife's gonna be fine. You got to put that aside and let yourself really be present with yourself and get that filled up time. I mean, really be present without the guilt and the shame. And the same goes on the other end. If I am, say, his wife, which I am, and he asks for time to go golf, we agreed upon it, yeah, it'll be good for you, he goes and golfs, I'm not going to beat him up or punish him for taking time away from the family or guilt him or shame him or create any drama.
Or call me while I'm on the ninth hole putting for the birdie putt saying, I don't know what's going on with the kids or...
Are you talking from past experience?
I don't know. Am I talking from past experience? I think I am. Yeah. I'm with the boys. I need to change diapers.
Yes.
No. All that basically is to come to an understanding that this is your time.
This
obviously, yes,
time.
If there is emergency, there is communication that needs to happen.
Oh my God, I'm just thinking of that time I locked Alex in the car because I put the car seat, he was just a baby. He was like, I think a month old, not even. And I put him in the car seat. And while I was putting him in the car seat, I put the keys in the front seat. And so I lock him in and I close the door and I go to open up my door and my keys were locked in the front seat and the baby's in the back. And I'm like, oh my God, what do I do? And I didn't have any phone numbers because this day and age, right? Everything's in my cell phone, which my cell phone and my purse were in the front seat. I had already locked the house to the car. I already locked the door to the house. So I couldn't get in the house. I couldn't get in my car. I didn't have my cell phone. I didn't remember a phone number. So I had to go across the street to one of my neighbor's house and call my mother who lives in Arizona. We were in Montreal. So I think it was like 8 a.m. It was early because I was off to get a cup of coffee because I was so tired to even make my own coffee at home. I just wanted to go to Tim Hortons and get a coffee. That was my outing for the morning and he had gone golfing. And so I had gone across the street so that my neighbor, I could call my mom so my mom could give me Frederick's cell phone number. And then she had to call you or something or
No, you called me from the neighbor's house.
From the neighbor's house.
To come over. It was a frantic call to come back home.
My newborn baby, I'm a new mom, right, is locked in the car. He was fine. He had fallen asleep. He wasn't traumatized or anything, but I was because I couldn't get to my baby. So, you know, that kind of stuff used to happen. Thank God doesn't anymore. But, you know, that's something that we had agree upon is that when he goes to golf, let the guy have a golf time.
Yeah, let the guy have a golf time. God damn, no frantic calls, please. I think that's what I meant. That's probably the call that I meant. Come back home!
I can't get in
my car. I need your help!
But then, again, there's also solutions, right? Because he didn't have to come back home. I called, I think we had a Ford, what was it, something. And I called the roadside assistance, and they came and popped the car open, and the baby was sleeping, and all was good, right? I'm not the same person I used to be 10, 11, 12 years ago. But, and I am much more calm about things, and I, you know, I let you have your time.
So see, there is... There is evolving in every relationship, and we're the proof of it. And again, if you need help, we are ready and willing to help you and coach you around that area, that space. Just go and fill out our forms at connectedcoupling.com.
connectedcoupling.com. So our next show is going to be the ing in coupling. Why are we saying coupling? Why don't we just say couple? Who is this show really for, and why are we doing this is our next show, because there's definite reasons why we're doing this, why my business has evolved into this, being a coach for over 17 years and an author and a speaker and, you know, helping coaches get certified and helping people learn about the seven essential laws. Why have I evolved into this, and why is
why
it important
have we been
for us?
Coming so, together to yeah. do this.
So come learn about the ing on our next episode. And again, thank you so much for watching. Go to connectedcoupling.com if you want to work with us one-on-one or two-on-one. Have an amazing day, everybody.
See you soon.
Thanks for listening to Conscious Coupling with Frederick Gobay and Christy Whitman. If you like our show and want to know more, check out ChristyWhitman.com. And please leave us a review on iTunes. Learn how to turn your partner into your soulmate. Join us again next week for another powerful episode.